Welcome back from the break. Now located in Rakana Village in Omoro District, Pascal Osire is growing and getting millions from the hot red pepper, commonly known as chili here in Uganda. The idea came to him at the start of the lockdown, and he has grown from 7 to 12 acres of land, selling a kilogram at 1,500 shillings. He has also invested in an irrigation project worth 26 million, which helps him produce paper all throughout the year.
My name's Pascal Osire. I call myself a small farmer in Kieto Village, Lakwana Sub-County, Omoro District, and that is northern Uganda. Now, I came here in 2019, and one of the projects that I started with was agroforestry. We planted trees. Thereafter, the first lockdown got me here. When the first lockdown got me here, I started thinking now outside the box, because vanilla is my business, and when they closed all the airports, meaning that we're not able to send. Even in the US, where we have our clients, the companies closed down. You have the material, but you cannot send. So I started developing an idea. I asked myself, what is the thing that I will grow and I sell locally so that we can get money to survive? Fortunately enough, I also attended I was in the Netherlands, and I attended the Uganda-Netherlands Business Convention. And one of the things that they talked about, and the companies that I interacted with, they were doing chilies, hot peppers, and so on. We also visited some farms, and then I said, now I started researching, what is the time? If I planted this, how long will it take for me to start getting money? So I sampled. I actually got seeds of chili and hot pepper very expensively. Actually, when I told some of the inspectors who came and visited me that I bought a cup that is not even a half a kilo at 300,000, they said these people just cheated you. But I told them, no, it's fine. It was a hard way of learning, but finally we learned it. So we put 2 acres of hot pepper, and we put 2 acres of chili. This area where we are, this is where we had put the hot pepper. And I can tell you, we did great. The hot pepper did great, the chili did great. Now remember, I have planted, but I have not yet even gotten the market, and we are in the lockdown. So after putting, because they taught me how to put it in the nursery bed, I did it myself with a few boys I have at the farm. The things started germinating very well, and after that we started the planting. And one thing that again that hit us hard was that the drought. So we planted, and we decided to cut the matoke, because we had planted matoke, cut kind of a covering with it, and then the sunshine hits the matoke. Evening, we had to do the watering ourselves as we were waiting for rains, because the first rain that came deceived us that it was the right time to plant. But all nonetheless, we managed to do that. And after that, my crops were very okay. And then now I started looking for a market. I said, hey, because one, I didn't even know at what stage am I going to harvest. I said, now it is time to look for a market. Fortunately enough, I called one of the guys who sold me the seeds, and he referred me to one of the inspectors in the ministry. And when I contacted the inspector at the Ministry of Agriculture, he was very, very cooperative. The guy told me it's okay, it is well. I had to get a letter from Gulu now, from RDC. I said, you know what? I have to go to Gulu. To Kampala. I need to do this and this and this. And good enough, the RDC gave me a letter. because the inspector also has no way, does not have any other car to come. So I had to drive up to Kampala. When I came with the inspector here, when a guy moved around the gardens, he got shocked. He said that I have never seen, I move around many farms, but I have never seen a good chili and hot pepper like this one. And I can tell you, my brothers and sisters, this is the guy even who got me a market. Because I remember when we were in the garden of the hot pepper, he called some guy, I think some Indian, who is one company that is exporting hot pepper, and he told him, I have gotten you the best hot pepper in Uganda. When we went to the chili garden, he said the same. And now he contacted those people, but we had to sample. We had to do the scouting for him to see, because we were not spraying them, we were not doing anything. So we did the scouting to see if there is an infection. Truly, in the hot pepper, there was some infection, some fruit flies that were gotten, and then he also gave us the remedies. He said, get this and get this. What we did, that is what we did it. In 1 week, all the gardens were clear. The chili was okay, it was only the hot pepper. And then now, from there, we started sending hot peppers, sending chilies, and it was in tons and tons. Actually, we could send like 2 tons, we could send like 3 tons, we could send like 2 tons, 1 ton, and that is was only 2 acres of hot pepper, two acres of chili. And one of the challenges that we got is the issue of transport, because remember, we have to transport this up to Kampala, and then from there it is taken to the park house. We had to sometimes hire a car to come from Kampala to pick this. Then we say, no, I think this is not right. By the time I went to the bank, because they were putting money in my account, by the time I went to the bank, I realized that I had money, enough money that can first sort out one problem, and that is the issue of transport. So when I called a friend of mine, an Indian who is running born in Kampala. He told me a truck is 76 million. I said, I want a box board, a building like this. He said, yes. And I can tell you, I paid money cash. I told him, give me the account number. I transferred the money. The man never believed me. And that was the fruit of hot pepper and chili. Now, this now gave me courage to continue to start now doing this as business. Remember, the other one was just sampling. Now this one gave me the courage. It gave me, you know, I interacted with very many people, exporters of this chili and hot pepper. Actually, I used to have Indians, different companies, people coming up to here. Even sometimes I get overwhelmed with the supplies, because I cannot, you know, manage to supply all the market that I have. So 2021, we said now we are going to go into really farming in our business. Then now there we put 5 acres of hot pepper, and then we did 7 acres of chili. I can tell you that these things have done great to us, because one of the things that I tell people, because I have been here, I am here myself, I'm a foot soldier when it comes to farming. It does not require a lot from you. Managing, the only thing that challenges a bit is hot pepper managing. But if you get a right person, because for me now, in case I see anything, I speak to these guys of the inspectors, they come and help me. Then also I get an agronomist who is helping me. But we have also trained the boys at the farm here to do the scouting, to do the work, because for them they are here all the time. Once they discover that there is a problem, they communicate to inspector. Inspector will say, buy this and this and this, and that's what we do. We have the best land in the northern Uganda that brings any crop. You know, one of the things again I did, I called a friend of mine who is a soil scientist, and we picked the samples of soils in every area in this land we have. And because I wanted to know which crops can come good, can grow well, which ones cannot grow well. And the results that came were so well that all crops can grow in the northern Uganda, can grow in this area where we are. That's why you see that when you look behind me, we have, this is all Gonja that is here. And I can tell you, even when you look at this gonja, the gonja that we have grown, it is on order. There is already order for it, and it has not yet even started putting. Now, this chili, the 7 acres of chili and the hot pepper, 5 acres, it has done well for us. Because the only challenge which is, but I don't call that a challenge, because you know, with the market, sometimes they go up and then they come down. But the most important thing is that the market is there. So I have been able to supply a number of companies. But of course, one of the things that you also don't need to miss out is that there are those also who steal. Because I remember there are some companies that I have supplied and they have cheated me. They have not even given me my money. And one of the other things is that building a trust with people, with the clients is also another thing. Why? You know, I have inspectors who come to my gardens every week, and they test everything. But when you give a client chili or hot pepper, tomorrow, I mean after 1 week, actually you'll not even get any communication. After 1 week or 2 weeks, you're asking, hey, I'm not seeing the money coming. They begin telling you that, you know, we got a chili or a hot pepper with an infection and it did not go. That was a very open way of stealing and so on. So what I have decided to do, because there are many of them, I have decided to zero in on those who are, even if they are giving me small money, but they don't cheat. So I have said I work with them, and they are also very okay. We are fine. We have made money. Actually, from the 7 acres of chili and the hot pepper, one of the things that I have done again, I have decided to reinvest this money. As you know, down there where we went there, where we're sampling that irrigation system that we have there, we have invested there 26 million, of which I paid cash to the guy who is doing irrigation. That money came from nowhere, but it came from this chili. And we are talking about, this is just something which is a short period. It is not yet one year. And then also, out of those 7 acres and then 8 acres, I mean 5 acres, of course, you know, I have a big number of people here who are working. I have boys who stayed at the farm here. They are 40, they are here permanent from January to January. Of course, you know, paying them and so on. We have money for that. None of them is saying they don't pay me. We provide eating and everything. We have also, because now what I'm telling you, it is last year. Not this year, because we are still just in January. Out of these 7 gardens of chili and also hot pepper, I have also managed to buy more 50 acres within this area. Because people come and say, I have 10 acres, I have 5 acres. I have been expanding within here. And it is not that I have some money again somewhere. All this money, it is coming from the chili. I have not yet also used the money that I want to buy a big car and so on. But I've said, since I'm getting this money from, let me first use it to expand this. But it has been a very profitable business for me, because I decided to go into this business, this farming as business. The only challenge we have with a number of farmers is that many people, when they go into something, they put in a lot of money. But when they are going into something, they want to spend small money. You have invested a lot of money to start. But when it comes to managing, people become so greedy, they want to put small money. That's why you see that many people don't get results. So I told you, I started in a hard way. But after, I decided now to put in the brains. When I see the problem that I see problems in my crops, I make a call, an inspector can drive from Kampala, will take care of that. And he comes and he does the scouting, he checks everything, and he will advise me accordingly. Now, if I say that, no, I cannot spend 1 million or 500,000 to bring somebody from there to come here, would you know the results? That means I'm going to lose millions of money instead of just 1 million to help me to get about 20 million. One of the things that we did also, we have grown. We have avocados, both Hass avocados and local avocados. Actually, when you see behind there, I think you can even see some avocado trees. We have them. And then we also have cashew nuts. Cashew nuts, we have 4 acres. Avocados, we have 7 acres, both Hass and local. I am, China has taught me a very good lesson. When I look at the markets, I say in agriculture, you'll never die poor. And that is where there is money. So I said, okay, fine. I need something that gives me money within the shortest period of time, and that is chili and hot pepper. Then I also said, but I need also to do something that will give me money in a period of two to three years. And what is that? That is when I went into, I got an idea now of growing cashew nuts and avocados. Then I also engaged myself in growing of vanilla. Vanilla, you know, we have vanilla there, 7 acres. And that is also the same period. That is for vanilla now. Have this gonja, as I told you, it is already, even the, before I bought a single sucker of gonja, I already had a market. The person called me and said, hey, if you can help me and put 50 acres, it would be okay. I told him I don't have that money. I will do it slowly by slowly, process by process. He told me it's okay, no problem. So today, we have 10 acres of gonja, and gonja is doing well. What you see here, they are not looking a bit good. It is not because that it is not the plants are, but the plants are good, but it is just the terrible heat that we are having in the northern Uganda. And then what else do we have? Okay, fine. When I talk about today, I told you the first project that I had here was agroforestry. So after planting the trees, I said that is the money that I need in the next 10 years.
It's not uncommon to look inside your wallet and wonder where all your money went, especially if you're not tracking your spending. But with our simple money management tips, you won't be able to suffer through that ever again. Here is our personal finance. Here are simple money management tips. 1. Create a comprehensive budget. Write down how much money you receive from your salary, bonuses, benefits, reimbursements, and other sources. Compare that to all your expenses and ensure you have enough money to cover everything you need. 2. Spend less by trimming day-to-day costs. Identify areas to save, such as on your cell phone and cable television plan, or by planning meals and groceries to avoid takeout lunches and last-minute ordering in. 3. Eliminate unnecessary costs. Make a list of your current bills and their due dates and pay your bills on time to avoid late fees and penalty charges. 4. Find ways to pay less interest on your debts. Focus on paying off debts with the highest interest rate first. Keep up with required payments such as monthly minimums on all your debts. Consolidate your debts into an all-in-one type of bank account or a secure line of credit. You can make a single payment each month. And 5. Set clear goals to help accelerate your savings. Write down all the things you are saving for, then work out how much you need to set aside each month to reach your goals in the time frame you want, then pay yourself this amount each month as if it was another bill.
The economy is finally open, and that's a very big trap for your money and mine too. But with these tips in mind, I hope that you will have a very good time shopping and won't spend unnecessarily. Here now is our report on Forex and money market. Thank you very much for making time to watch the show tonight. We do appreciate your time every week. The budget is out, there are discussions everywhere, and you need to pay attention so that you know what's affecting you as a trader. And we shall always be looking out for you to give you information concerning business in Uganda. Follow us on social media and also watch on YouTube our episodes. I'll see you next time. Good night.